Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Well, we've all been there. We take a few days of vacation to go to the beach or wherever our heart desires, and then you return home to face phone calls, deadlines, reports, and hundreds of emails. The amount of work that many people face after returning from vacation is enough to stop them from wanting to take another one. Well, joining us today with some tips on how to reduce post-vacation stress is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapo. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, what exactly is post-vacation stress?
It's what I'm feeling now, just a little bit.
Yeah, because you recently just got back from vacation.
We just got back, and I'm trying to follow the advice that I'm about to give you. But it's really that feeling of kind of being overwhelmed, of dealing with everything, the phone calls, et cetera. And the sad thing is, a lot of times it ends up canceling out the benefit of that vacation. And you don't want that to happen, because we spend a lot of time and resources and money sometimes on that vacation. So we have to learn what to do before, during, and after so that that doesn't happen.
Yeah, and then sometimes on vacation, we can't just sit back, chill, and relax. Why is that? Because we're thinking about all the stuff that we've got to do when we come back.
Yes, and I'm one of those people. And part of that is because we haven't prepared on the front end. So I think it's really, really important before you go to do really just two things. Number one, make a priority list of what you need to do when you get back, and take that list with you. And I'll tell you what to do with it in a minute. But the other thing is to let people know that you're leaving. And I say that because in this day and age with smartphones and internet, et cetera, if you don't say to people, I am leaving, I will not be available, I will not be checking my emails or only checking intermittently, they assume you're in the loop. So it's really important to make that message clear. I'm gone. Don't count on me for the next 4 or 5 days.
Speaking of which, I will not be here on Friday or Monday, so
see,
I'm going to need y'all to keep
no emails
to
her.
Okay. So what else do we need to do?
While you're there, obviously make the vacation a priority. But if you're like me and you just can't disconnect completely, if you're going to work, work at schedule time. So maybe a little bit in the morning, maybe a little bit in the afternoon, just so that the work doesn't kind of bleed over into the whole vacation. And then the night before, when you're headed back, a lot of people, again, myself included, you start thinking about, what do I have to do when I get home? And it can be kind of anxiety provoking. That's when you take out that priority list and you start working it.
Okay.
Change it, add things. Basically what you're doing is you're taking that stress you're starting to feel and you're making it productive. First day back in the office, breathe, take deep breaths, and remind yourself you're not going to catch up that first day. Focus on the priority list, and again, now tell people, hey, I'm back in the office. Mm-hmm. I need just a couple of days to catch up. That communication is really important. You do those things before, during, and after, and the level of anxiety that you'll have when you come back definitely be reduced.
All right. Well, thank you so much. My problem is just the housework that's just waiting on you when you get back. It's just horrible. And the laundry is piled up to here.
One day at a time when you get back.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Josh. Very timely for
My pleasure,
for me and you too. All right. Now I'll send it over to Kaylee.